now at the Douglas Family Preserve, and with me is Linda Kropp, Chief Counsel of the Environmental Defense Center. How are you, Linda?
I'm good, thank you.
Linda, what's the mission of the Environmental Defense Center?
We are a nonprofit here in Santa Barbara, and we also do work in Ventura and San Luis Obispo counties. Our mission is to protect our local environment through education, advocacy, and even legal action if necessary. So we help other groups in the community protect open spaces like the Douglas Family Preserve, help protect our environment from pollution, help protect our air quality and water quality and our ocean environment.
When was it founded?
We were founded in 1977, shortly after the 1969 oil blowout. And the reason we were formed was because after the 1969 oil spill, there were a lot of new groups that formed. A lot of people had a renewed awareness in how important it is to protect our environment. And also, a lot of federal environmental protection laws were passed. And so you had this whole community of activists and people concerned about the environment trying to use these new environmental protection laws, and they needed some help to do that. So we were actually formed to pretty much be the environmental lawyers for our community.
Now, I know you have a lot of programs, and obviously they all have issues related to the environment. Let's start talking about the environmental justice program. How does it work?
Well, our main concern there is to try to protect people from exposure to pesticides and other toxic chemicals in the environment. And we reach out to people who may be a little less served or less educated on the issue. Go into the communities, we work with farm workers. We've been trying to get our local public parks and schools pesticide free, and we've been very successful in that effort. But we're also trying to work with farmers, trying to reduce pesticide use, because a lot of times the people that are the most exposed, the farm workers, have the least protections and the least representation. And so we've been trying to reach out to all aspects of our community to protect people.
Now, I know that you have a lot of efforts put on biodiversity. Could you explain us more about that?
Sure. Well, we are very fortunate to live in one of the biodiversity hotspots on the planet, believe it or not, because where we live on the Pacific coast. We have cool northern Pacific waters that meet warm southern Pacific waters, and they mix here. So you get northern species, southern species, and species that rely on that mix. So we have incredible biodiversity right here in the Santa Barbara Channel and along the Gaviota Coast. And so we've done a lot of work to try to protect the ecological integrity of this area. We've been working to protect the Gaviota Coast. We do a lot of work with the Channel Islands National Park and Marine Sanctuary. We're trying to protect whales that migrate through the channel. So we're trying to protect all of these species and animals and their habitats for future generations.
What about water? I know you monitor the quality of water in our area. How do you do that?
Well, we work with other groups like the Santa Barbara Channel Keeper. Heal the Ocean does a lot of good work in that area, and Surf Rider Foundation. And what we try to do is work with other groups and identify areas of concern. And so if we find that there are, you know, polluted waterways, we can bring lawsuits under the Clean Water Act. But we also try to do a lot of education. We helped the county and the city form Project Clean Water as using education as a tool to try to clean up water quality and try to get people to do the right thing without having to file lawsuits. And that's been a very successful effort.
Now, one of the most interesting things that you do is to protect land and also allow public access. How do you manage both?
Well, they're definitely related. Protecting open space areas and protecting public access often go hand in hand, especially at a place like the Douglas Family Preserve, where we are now, as well as Carpinteria Bluffs and Elwood out in Goleta. All of those places were threatened with development that not only would have paved over important habitats, but also would have prevented public access. One of our other programs is to try to restore our watersheds that we have here along the coast. And the way we do that is by trying to bring steelhead back into the watershed system. Steelhead are important because they tell us, they're kind of a keystone species, and they tell us how healthy our watershed is in terms of water pollution, in terms of how much water is flowing in the river. So what we're trying to do is restore our watersheds for fish, for people, for drinking water supply, and for habitat.
Also would like to ask you about the offshore oil and gas program.
This is one of our most important programs. It's been 40 years since the 1969 oil spill, and yet we still have about 20 oil platforms off of our coast. More oil development is constantly being proposed, especially offshore Santa Barbara County. And so one of our priorities has been to stop any new development, but also get rid of what's here. We still have oil spills. We still have toxic gas leaks that affect our community. And so what we're trying to do is work with the federal government. We have a new administration now, and try to continue the protection for the California coast that we enjoyed for so many years.
Tell me more about your staff members.
We have a great team. And one thing I'd like to point out is one of the benefits of working at the Environmental Defense Center is we have a great team within our organization, but we also get to work with most of the other environmental groups in town because they will hire us on different issues. And so the team actually expands even beyond the Environmental Defense Center into the community. At the Environmental Defense Center, we have a team of lawyers as well as environmental analysts. And so we work on education. We have program areas like our environmental health project, our marine sanctuary project. We have environmental analysts that help us work with scientists and other experts and bring that kind of expertise to the issues.
Sure, and this will be a great time if you can share your website and phone number.
Sure, our website is www.edcnet.org. That's www.edcnet.org. And our phone number is 805-963-1622.
Well, thank you, Linda, for all that information. And if you want to volunteer, you got the website and the phone number. And again, I wish you the best for you and your organization.
Thank you very much.
For more information on the Nonprofit Spotlight, check our website at www.sbchannels.tv or call 963-3893. If you'd like your nonprofit featured in a future Nonprofit Spotlight, contact us at the information on your screen.